All right, good to go. Well, hey, are you enjoying yourself tonight? All right, well, we've got two ladies that are enjoying themselves. Everybody else is busy talking, but that's a good thing. So, are you enjoying yourself tonight? Yeah! Well, awesome. I want to say it's great to have Bethel Assisted Living listening as well tonight. They got their windows open, so we love you guys over there. We're glad that you're able to enjoy tonight with us. Well, I'm excited to be able to share with you for just a little bit out of God's Word. If you don't attend Hillside Assembly and you've never heard me speak before, I'm just going to prep you right now. You might need to buckle your seatbelts. I can be a little passionate when it comes to God's Word. I love the Word of God. I love the Bible. And I love it most when we're able to take it and apply it to our life. And I feel like tonight, God wants to speak to you. He wants to speak to you directly. And encourage you in right where you're at, whatever you're dealing with, whatever issues are going on in your life. And tonight, I want to share with you about a man named Ezekiel. Ezekiel was an interesting guy because he came from a family of pastors. He was like multi-generational lineage in the ministry. So his dad was a pastor, his granddad and his great-granddad all served the Lord as pastors or priests. But the time that Ezekiel was living in, when God had called him to preach the Word of God and to share the Word of God with people, to bring hope, it was a very challenging time. It was a very difficult time. Ezekiel was in this place where God's people had been exiled. They were exhausted. It was such a challenging time. The Word of God tells us that the hope literally ran out of the people. The air literally had been knocked out from them. I don't know if you've ever had a moment like that where you've had the wind knocked out of you. I have several brothers, and we grew up, we used to play football in the street and on an Air Force base that we lived at in Dyess Air Force Base in Texas. And occasionally we would play in the backyards. And when we played in the backyards, there was every so many houses, there was these electrical boxes that came out of the ground. You've seen them, they're green. And I remember one time I was running, they threw the pass, I was wide open, but it was just a little out of my reach, and I dove for the ball and I high-centered myself right on that green post. And I remember feeling like, I'm dead. I've died. I just, they came, my friends came and they peeled me off. My brothers there, they peeled me off of this thing. They laid me down. My limbs were all collapsed. I couldn't breathe. I was, gasping for air because the wind had been knocked out of me. There's nothing like that feeling. And that's where God's people were. That's where this nation was. They felt the wind had been knocked out of them. But I think this, there's a lot of comparison to maybe where we're at today, both personally, but also as a community and as a country. We've been through a lot over the last year, and it can feel a little bit like the wind's been knocked out of us. If you look at just this last week and things that we're facing as a nation, gas shortages on the East Coast. We've got the humanitarian crisis at our border, which is absolutely astronomically horrible. We've got unemployment at a high rate. And even here in Ripon, we've got stores closing in the middle of the day because we don't have enough workers to keep them open. You see inflation happening across the board, especially in the price of building supplies. I read just 2 days ago, and somebody told me that this number is old, that it's higher than this now, but the price of wood for construction is up 127%. The pews in our church have never been worth more. People are hurting everywhere. They're scared, and they feel like the air has been knocked out from them. But I want to tell you, all those thousands of years ago when God spoke to a man, Ezekiel, which I'm about to read from that conversation, God has a plan and God wants to do something greater. He wanted to do something greater through Ezekiel and the people of Israel at that time. And I want to tell you tonight, God wants to do something greater in your life. He wants to do something greater in Ripon and in our surrounding communities. So I want to share with you the conversation that God had with Ezekiel. God gives Ezekiel this vision or dream. And we're going to step into this conversation that he has with God during this vision and dream. It's out of Ezekiel chapter 37. And it reads like this. The Lord took a hold of me, and I was carried away by the Spirit to a valley of dry bones. A valley filled with dry bones. He led me all around among the bones that covered the valley floor. They were scattered everywhere across the ground. They were completely dried out. Then he asked me, "Son of man, can these bones become living people again?" What a great question. What a great question tonight. Can these bones become living people again? That same question is being asked by God tonight about our lives, right here in this parking lot. If you're hearing this on the airwaves, you're watching this later on YouTube or Facebook, God is asking you that question right now. Can these bones live again? That's an interesting question. And Ezekiel had a perfect answer. "O sovereign Lord, you alone know the answer to that." Ezekiel wasn't trying to deflect the question. He wasn't trying to be tricky with God. His heart was just in that place where he's like, "God, I don't have the answer, and only you know that." And I think right now in this season of our life, we're coming out of this crazy pandemic, all these other things that we're going to be facing in the months and years ahead. The road's going to be challenging. And God's asking a question tonight. Can these bones, can they come to life again? The air might be gone tonight. You feel lonely. You feel left out. You feel depressed. You're facing situations and circumstances in your life that are so overwhelming. You're feeling like, I feel like I'm not even alive. God's asking you tonight, can they live again? And do you have the courage to go, "God, I don't know, but I know that you do."
Amen. Yes.
I know that you have an answer. God has an answer for you. He's got an answer for our community and all the surrounding communities around us tonight. God wants to do something greater. The conversation goes on, and it reads like this. I'm going to read the whole rest of the conversation for you and then sum it up. Then he said to me, "Speak a prophetic message to these bones." Now, we hear prophetic. I want to clarify something. We hear that, and I know a lot of people automatically think, "Uh-oh, it's cuckoo for Cocoa Puff time." But I want to tell you, a prophetic word is not scary. And I know in a lot of church cultures, we've taken a prophetic word, and we're looking to something mysticism. But that's not what a prophetic word is. A prophetic word is a word that comes from God to a person, and then that person relays that word. That's what the word of God is. The gift of being a prophet should be happening every single Sunday morning in churches across our nations as pastors take the pulpit and speak the word of God to the people that are in attendance at their church. So it's not something crazy, it's not something weird, but it is something incredibly powerful when God speaks to his people. And this is what he spoke to Ezekiel. He said, speak a prophetic message to these dry bones. Dry bones, listen to the word of the Lord. This is what the sovereign Lord says. Look, I am going to put breath into you and make you live again. I'll put flesh and muscle on you. I'll cover you with skin. I'll put breath in you and you will come to life. Then you will know that I am the Lord. So I spoke this message just as he told me. Suddenly, as I spoke, there was a rattling sound across the valley. The bones of each body came together and attached themselves as complete skeletons. Then, as I watched, muscle and flesh formed over the bones. The skin formed to cover their bodies, but they still had no breath in them. Then he said to me, speak a prophetic message to the winds, son of man. Speak a prophetic message and say, this is what the sovereign Lord says. Come, O breath from the four winds. Breathe into these bodies so they may live again. So I spoke this message as he commanded me, and breath came into their bodies. They all came to life and stood up on their feet, a great army. Amazing. Then he said to me, son of man, these bones represent the people of Israel. They are saying, we have become old, dry bones. All hope is gone. Our nation is finished. Therefore, prophesy to them and say, this is what the sovereign Lord says. O my people, I will open your graves of exile and cause you to rise again. Then I will bring you back to the land of Israel. When this happens, O my people, you will know that I am the Lord. I will put my spirit in you and you will live again and return home to your own land. Then you will know that I am the Lord and I have spoken. I have done what I said. Yes, the Lord has spoken. This vision that Ezekiel was given of these dry bones coming back to life as he spoke the word of God was an illustration of what he was about to do in the people that he desperately loved, for the people of Israel. And I want to tell you tonight, just like Jesus loved the people of Israel and still loves the people of Israel, he loves you tonight. He loves Ripon and Omro and Princeton and all these other communities, Green Lake and Berlin. He loves our communities. And he's about to do something greater than we've ever seen. God's about to breathe fresh life into people who are desperate, into people who have no hope, who feel their life is over, who are facing situations where they feel this is the end, there's nothing left. God's about to move and bring restoration to your life. He's about to restore marriages. He's about to bring kids back home who've been lost and going down these paths and making choices that are poor decisions. He's about to call them back home and change their lives forever. Are you ready to experience what God has for you? Worship team, if you'd come back. Robbie, if you'd play just a little bit right now. I don't believe God's word is just for Sunday morning. I believe it's 24/7. That when God speaks, we have an opportunity to respond to him. And tonight, we can talk about other people. We can point to other people. But I know right here in this parking lot tonight, I know that there are people that are broken. These bones, they seem like they're dried up. Maybe you're thinking, could God really do a miracle for me? I mean, I believe he can do it for somebody else, but for me? I want to tell you, we serve a God who still does miracles. Amen. He still heals people. This last winter, our church went a little bananas. As we faced the pandemic, we made a decision that we wanted to be a beacon of hope for our communities. And while so many people did not feel comfortable coming, it's inside buildings, we said, let's take the word of God outside. And we started preaching the word last summer. We went into the fall, and then we made a decision. We were going to do it all winter long, and we did. It was crazy, but God did some amazing things and changed some people's lives. I don't regret that decision, not for one instant. For 2.5 years, I suffered with a disease, COVID-9 vesiculation syndrome. My muscles would spontaneously spasm. I had the rarest form. It wasn't isolated to one part of my body. It was all over my body. There'd be days where I would be in so much pain. I wouldn't want to get out of bed. But every day I faced it with courage, knowing that God had called me. And I remember praying as we went into the fall and into the winter. And I prayed for healing. I wanted to be healed. But I'd come to a place where God had wrestled with me, because I believe as following Christ, there are times and seasons you have to suffer. And I remember coming to the point where I was okay. I talked with God and said, Lord, if I have this for the rest of my life, I realize it will limit me. I'll have limitations. But that's okay, because I'm still going to give you everything I have to serve the kingdom. And I remember telling God, it's my privilege and honor to preach to this community in the middle of the winter outdoors. It was some of the greatest moments of my life, of my ministry career. And then one Sunday, God showed up and healed me. Hallelujah. And I have not had any more vesiculations. My eyes haven't gyrated once since that day. Very seldom I have just one or two little twinges. But I haven't had any spasm. I haven't had any pain from my condition. I believe God has completely healed me. He told me He would do it, and He did it. I'm standing here as a testimony, because I don't deserve it. But how good is God's grace? And if He could do it for me, I can tell you, I can assure you, He will do it for you. I'd like to ask you, if you just need a touch from God tonight, you need to experience a miracle, and you go, I don't even know if I believe in God. That's okay. That's okay. Yeah, but if you know that you need a miracle in your life, we want to pray for you tonight. We're not going to do anything weird. We're not going to run around and give everybody wet willies. We're not doing anything weird like that. God's power is so much greater than that. Would you be willing to stand to your feet tonight if you need a miracle for you, for your family, for a friend? You need a healing. You need a financial miracle. You need a physical miracle. I want to pray for you tonight, that as we worship, God would show up in your life. And just like He moved in my life and healed me, He would heal you. So would you stand to your feet tonight if you need a miracle in your life? I want to give you just a few moments to respond before we pray. Don't be intimidated. If you're in your car and you can't physically get out, that's fine. Turn on your lights. Turn on your lights just so we know that there's someone we're praying for tonight. Thank you for standing. Worship team, would you stretch your hand out tonight to everybody out here? We're going to pray over you. And I believe that tonight's going to start something great in your life. Jesus, we lift your name up. Your word says, we lift you up, you would draw all men unto you. We lift you up over Ripon and our surrounding communities. Lord, the promise that you gave Ezekiel, the words that you gave, you said, speak a prophetic word. Speak the words I give you. God, I know you've spoken to me, that you are about to do greater things in Ripon and these communities. God, I speak your word tonight. And I ask for a favor, that your spirit would fall, that your wonders would never cease, that your spirit would never leave, that Holy Spirit, you would come. And God, as we sing these next two sets of songs, that God, you would set people ablaze, that you would speak to their hearts, and that you would let them know they are not alone, and that the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, Jesus Christ, the one who conquered death in the grave, stands before them, and that you will do great things in their lives. I pray for healings to begin to take place. God, just not in us here, but Lord, across our community tonight. God, I pray for marriages to be restored. I pray for your power to be set free in this place. And the people who have struggled with addiction, God, it would be broken in their life once and for all. God, do amazing healings in people's bodies, their minds, their spirits tonight. Lord, situations that are far beyond our control, would you step in and intervene, and to you be the glory. May no man take credit for what the King of Kings does. If you've got a relationship with Jesus tonight, would you just lift your hands and begin to just ask God to pour out his spirit tonight? If you're here tonight and you don't have a relationship with Jesus, I want to tell you, he will change your life. He took a young punk kid, a military brat, with such a messed up life. And he set me free, and he put a fire in me, and called me just like he called Ezekiel. And I want to tell you, I wouldn't change a thing. Accepting Jesus Christ as my Savior is the single greatest decision I ever made in my life, and I never regret it. If you're here and you need a relationship with Jesus, I want to pray for you tonight. We admit that we're sinners, and everyone on this worship team is a sinner. We're messed up, and all that means is we're broken. We're not perfect. And we can't fix ourselves. But we've got a Savior who said, I can fix what's wrong in your life. And so we surrender. We ask Jesus to come into our life, and we say we want to start following you and help us to follow you, and then we do life as a church. We do life together. Our church is full of imperfect people. But we love Jesus and we love each other and we love you. So I want to pray for you tonight. If you need Jesus as your Savior and you want to start that relationship, would you pray these words with me tonight? Jesus, I'm a sinner. I'm broken. I've got issues. I've got problems. And I need you to come save me. I believe that Jesus, you are the Son of God, that you came, that you died, that you rose again, and that in this very moment you are calling out to me to start a relationship with you. So Lord, I surrender my life. Help me to start following you, to learn what that means, and change me from the inside out. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. I want to tell you tonight, if you don't have a church family, if you don't have a church that you attend, I don't want to rob people from other churches. That's not my mission. That's not the mission of our church. But if you don't have a church home, there's a place here where you can call home, where you can be loved on, and where we can help you grow in your relationship with Jesus. We do service at 10 a.m. on Sunday mornings. You can check us out online. Go ahead and do that. We've got more ministries coming and some great events coming in the future, later this summer and into the fall, we'd love for you to be a part of. But tonight, I just want to let you know God has started something in your life and he will see it to completion.
Yes,
I believe it.
Yes.
And I'm happy to walk with you and the people up here. And some of our people are out here in the parking lot. We will walk with you.
Yes.
We do life together. Let's end tonight by doing two more worship sets. I'm excited to cut loose and just worship God. I hope you are too. Can we do that?
Yes. Yeah.
Let's do it now. Jeremy, come and lead us, brother. Thank you guys for letting me share the word with you tonight. I'll come back and close us up here at the end.
All right. So the pastor asked me to lead in worship. I've only sang in front of people like once before. So yeah, bear with me. But it's not about the performance. It's about just worshiping Jesus for who he is.
Thanks, so, brother.
need to find my music here. Okay, so this next song, the pastor was talking about earlier some lyrics from an old Third Day song, May Your Wonders Never Cease. I think this is off of the same album, but it's also by Third Day, so God of Wonders. I just feel like it's just good to know that God is holy when we are not, and that our fallenness and our sin will always be holy. Thank you, Lord. So this next song, everyone should know it. It's the same four chords. It's Revelation song.
Worthy is the Lamb who was slain.
Take a couple minutes so we can get ready for Robin's set. Thank you.
Invite everyone who participated in the worship team to come up and sing with us tonight. So if you help us out tonight, you're going to come join us up here up front. So make your way up front right now, because we're going to end the night with some songs of celebration. Are you ready to do that?
Yeah!
We are going to do some celebrating tonight. We're going to let all of Ripon hear that we're celebrating Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Can we do that?
Yeah!
All right, so are we all up here, first of all? We're good. Everyone is here, right? I don't know if we all have mics, but we don't need a mic to sing. We can just sing out loud and some worship. What a great night it's been so far, isn't it?
Yes.
Just to worship the Lord. Powerful message. Are we all set?
No, I'm not set.
We're getting set right now. Technical difficulties. But it's going to be worth it, all right?
Teams are getting ready for the last set tonight. We wanted to let you know we have several other nights planned. We're announcing tonight that our next outdoor event will be on August 15th. It will not be at night. It will actually be on a Sunday morning at 10 a.m. in this field that's behind you. We're going to have a church service out here followed by a barbecue. We would love for you to come out to that. We'll be posting more information on that as it gets closer. That's August 15th. In September and October, we're hoping to bring back two worship nights, one each month. And in September, we're announcing tonight, we're also going to be doing a brat fry, and we're going to raise some money for missions and make a difference in some missionaries' lives. So we look forward to those events in the near future. But hey, are we ready to rock and roll now? Not quite. We're so close. They're like, preach one more message, Pastor. Preach one more message. But hey, I just want to say again, we just love having you guys here. I'm going to let Robin close tonight, so I wanted to invite you back to church one last time. If you don't have a church home, 10 a.m. on Sunday morning, we would love for you to come and just experience a worship experience with us. We'd love to have you here on Sunday. And we're going to continue to pray for you. Check us out on Facebook and YouTube. We're always putting content out there to just try to encourage you to follow Jesus and to continue to give your life over to Him, because God is doing great things and greater things are still to come.
That's right. All right, Romans 6:13 says, offer yourselves to God as those who have been brought from death to life. Offer every part of yourself to Him as an instrument of righteousness. We're here to offer our lives to God in worship. Tyler and Jeremy and Mike, are you ready to introduce this song? Now we need to help them out a little bit, so we got to clap. Let's put our hands together like this. This first song is called My Testimony. God has given us a testimony. He has brought us from death to life. Just like the message that Pastor Eric shared tonight, God brings dead things to life, and He has brought us to life. I saw Satan fall like lightning. I saw darkness run for cover. But the miracle that I just can't get over, my name is registered in heaven. I grew demon signs and wonders. I have resurrection power. Still the miracle that I just can't get over. My name is registered in heaven. My praise belongs to You forever. This is my testimony from death to life. Wrote my story, I'll testify. By Jesus Christ the righteous, I'm justified. This is my testimony, this is my testimony. Come together, sons and daughters, bought with blood and washed in water. praises of the Spirit, Son, and Father, our God will finish what He started. Our God will finish what He started. This is my testimony from death to life. The praises you wrote my story, I testify. By Jesus Christ the righteous, I'm justified. This is my testimony. This is my testimony. Now we're gonna sing this bridge. If I'm not dead, you're not done. We're alive. Let's sing it. If I'm not dead, you're not done. Greater things are still to come. Oh, I believe. If I'm not dead, you're not done. Greater things are still to come. Sing it again. If I'm not dead. If I'm not dead, you're not done. Do you believe it? Greater things are still to come. Oh, I, one more time. If I'm not dead, you're not done. Greater things are still to come. Oh, I believe. Let's sing that chorus. This is my testimony. This is my testimony. From death to life. This great rewrote my story. I'm I love worshiping God. I don't know about you. It is so great to worship the Lord. Kathy, hit that E. Power whenever you're ready. All right, here's the second song of celebration. We have a testimony, and the good news is He's not done. He's not going to stop what He's doing. There's greater things yet to come. Do you believe that? Let's sing it. Won't stop now. I know breakthrough is coming, and He won't stop now. I give You glory for all You brought me through, and now I'm ready. Are you ready? I'm moving forward to follow after You. And now I'm ready to whatever You want to do. It's His presence, Your presence. Your presence is an open door. Aren't you thankful that God is a God who keeps his promises? That was part of my devotions this morning, that God is a God who keeps his promises, and we can trust him. We're going to do one last song. Mike and Tyler, you're up. I love this next song. The first song we sang talked about we have a testimony. Second song that I led, God's not going to stop, he's going to keep on going. And we're going to start playing here in a second here, right?
Right.
And the third song is what makes it possible. And that is that we are a child of love. How great is the Father's love that he has lavished on us, that we should be called the children of God. God has empowered us to do awesome things for him. Do you believe that? That he's got a plan for you? And it's all because you are his child. I'm his child. You're his child. We're all his children. So let's sing this song, Child of Love.
I belong to you. Yeah.
nothing can change the way you love me. Nothing can change the way
I belong to you.
Yes, I do. Nothing can separate.
Here we go, Adrian.
I'm gonna climb the mountain.
Come on, put your hands together.
I am a child of love.
I am a child.
I am a child of love.
I thank you that you allow us to walk in victory, even through the toughest storms of life. God, you are with us. God, remind us each and every day that we are your child, that you've got a plan for us that is awesome. Every person, God, there's not one of us that is excluded because we are all your children. God, as we join our hearts together as a church body, I pray that we would impact this community. God, let your will be done. Set people free. Let your presence just pour over this place, this whole city. God, pour out your spirit. God, do miracles. Bring healing. Restore hope. Restore families. God, we surrender everything to you. God, remind us of what our vision and what our purpose is. Connect, grow, and go. God, you first of all want us to connect with you. May we worship you each day. And then may we grow in a relationship with you and go where you are calling us to go. Thank you, Jesus, for your presence. As we go our separate ways now, God, may we continue to worship you. In Jesus' name we pray. And everybody say, amen. I think we're just going to play this again.
Hey, as you guys leave tonight, it is dark here in our parking lot. We realize that it gets really dark here. We have some guys in green vests, fluorescent green vests. They're going to help you guys pull out tonight. Kids, please make sure, and ladies in green vests, please make sure that if you're a child, please, we don't want you playing right now. We don't want anybody run over. And as you're exiting, please exit slowly. We want to make sure everybody leaves tonight in a great way. We'll see you guys hopefully on Sunday. If not, we'll see you August 15th for sure out here. It's going to be a great night. And I am so proud of our amazing worship team tonight, honoring God with their gifts. Thank you guys so much. I could not be prouder as your pastor. Guys, have an amazing night. We'll see you soon.